So we shall
Thank
go
you,
on
ma'am.
to our next speaker. The third to follow is another super surgeon who heads the center of Agrawal Group of Hospitals at the Tirunelveli branch. And it was interesting to note that he dabbles into a whole lot of subspecialty practices besides a cataract. So let's hear this dynamic guy show a case of his with its own learning tip. On to you, Dr. Lionel Raj.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Is my screen visible, ma'am?
Toric trifocal implant.
Yes. Yes, can you start?
Yes, ma'am, 1 minute.
A 44-year-old male with dense posterior subcapsular cataract was taken up for a cataract surgery with toric trifocal implant. An online toric calculator was used with Barrett's formula. Based on flat meridian of 135, steep meridian of 45 degrees, and IOL spherical equivalence of plus 22 diopters, a TFNT60 model of IOL with 43 degree fixation was planned. After a microphacoemulsification, a toric trifocal IOL was successfully placed and aligned at 43 degrees, the desired axis. The viscoelastic substances were removed completely from the bag and the surgeon was happy after a successful centration of the lens. Perhaps the patient was not happy. On postoperative day 1, there was a refractive surprise of plus 3 diopter sphere and minus 7 diopter cylinder at 45 degree with IOL in the specified axis, position of 43 degrees. Warren Hill has described 4 possible errors with misaligned toric IOLs, of which interchanged axis is an important source of error in our case. The options left for me were rotating the IOL or exchange of IOL. I proceeded to rotate. An online toric results analyzer was used. After marking the originally placed IOL parameters and the amount of refractive residue, the results were obtained. Rotating the toric IOL 87 degree clockwise to a newer axis of 136 degrees was expected to correct up to 4.5 diopters of astigmatism, in this case, and a residual 1.87 diopters of astigmatism was anticipated. The patient was then taken back to the OR as early as on day 3. The new axis of 136 degree was marked manually. The incision and the bag was opened up very easily as they were fresh. With adequate OVD, the mobility of the IOL was then ensured. After sufficiently filling the anterior chamber and the bag with OVD, the IOL was gently rotated to the new desired position of 136 degrees with maximal ease, following which the viscoelastics were removed and the wounds were secured well. The postoperative day 1 and after 2 months, the residue was less than a diopter of sphere and 2 diopters of cylinder as predicted. By 2 months, a surface excimer ablation helped in achieving 20/30 N6 vision with no residual refractive errors, and the patient was happy. To conclude, toric IOLs with or without multifocality are sometimes associated with misalignments. Accurate planning and verification of axis are very important. Interchanged axis was a blunder in our case and required an early resurgery. Use of online refixation calculators ensure toric IOLs are forgiving lenses and not necessary to be exchanged.
That was a good one, Dr. Lionel Raj.
Thank you.
Now, in your experience, this was done within a week, right? This
yes,
particular
ma'am.
Care. Mm. So how late have you tried to rotate your IOLs?
Generally, yes, ma'am. Generally, toric IOLs, even as advocated by American Academy, we need to wait for at least 7 days, generally, before refixations. Whereas in this particular case, since it is transposition of axis, and either I have to remove the lens or rotate to a newer axis, which is beyond 30 degrees of originally placed axis. So I decided to go ahead at the early stage. Because once if the fibrosis or adhesions occur, then I may be challenging the bag as well, the zonules. So that's the reason I thought of going ahead very early.
In which kind of a scenario would you have thought of an IOL exchange altogether? Here, of course, it made sense because it was a error on your part. But if this was not that, would you have considered an exchange in its place?
Yes, ma'am. That was number two option in my mind. The very reason why I wanted to present this for the audience is also toric IOLs need not be exchanged all the times. There are ways that we can still retain the existing IOL, reposition them, and with the help of bioptic procedures, we can still retain the forgiving lens. There are some times where if the power calculation itself is wrong, the spherical equivalence, then all those are the situations I would definitely would have gone for exchange.
Anything to add from the expert panel? Dr. Suhas, Dr. Ramurti.
I think, Lionel, I mean, are you using a digital overlay?
We have, sir, but this is this was done little earlier.
No. The reason I'm asking this is, you know, your rotation was by 90 degrees, and that's too extreme. And that's the reason you did it on the first post-operative day. If at all rotation is needed of these toric IOLs to a small extent, what is recommended by the American Academy, what we also follow, is about at the end of 2 to 3 weeks. Mm-hmm. But that's when the wound, as the main wound, has healed and astigmatism is quite stable. And then not in the first week, 2 to 3 weeks later, you rotate. When you have a 7 day after a cylinder left over, like in your case, obviously it's better to intervene quickly. The reason I asked whether you are using a digital marker is, like in the very on, you have a overlay which tells you the toric axis. At 90 degrees to it, you have another dotted line, which is slightly. I did a mistake of, you know, in my hurry, just aligning it with that line. And that's the reason the lens was malpositioned by 90 degrees. But obviously, otherwise, if you're using a manual marking, getting a misalignment by 90 degrees is something which is very surprising. And the lenses don't also rotate that much. And secondly, I know you are a fantastic surgeon and you're a very good friend, but I'm going to be pretty harsh on you. I believe that you didn't do much for this patient at all. You started with 3 diopters of cylinder, and with all this gymnastics, you left him with 2 diopters of cylinder, which had to be taken care of by laser vision correction. Something wrong with the calculation, something wrong with what was done. I mean, this is not a normal results. I mean, I don't know whether your initial IOL power calculation is something wrong with that.
So that's what I was telling, sir. It is the interchange of the axis during calculation. It is a manual error.
It's a blunder.
It's a blunder. I do agree. It's a blunder. I didn't want others to do, because it's most often we just go ahead with the optometrist working for us. Yes. This is a learning case for me. After this, each and every toric case, I verified my own with a preoperative op scan as well. Before calculation,
is, you know, I myself, I did this blunder once, in the sense that I aligned it with the other line, and then I had to go the next day and found that it's 90 degrees off because I was using a Varion toric overlay. But after you did the rotation also, you just reduce the preoperative cylinder by one diopter. I mean, this patient was still left behind with two diopters of cylinder. That's not something that we normally experience.
Yes, sir. But that was predicted by Bödel Hatton axis fixation.
So that's when you use the Barrett RX formula, which gives you three alternatives: whether to rotate the lens, whether to put exchange a feedback lens, or exchanging the lens. What's exchange the new IOL power? So you have to look at what's the residual power, and if it's two diopters, right, the cylinder is going to be left behind after.
You would have got it out.
Yeah, I would have exchanged the lens, not just rotate the lens.
Got it.
Can I add one small point, ma'am?
Yes, Sasha.
Dr. Lionel.
Yes.
You showed that when you were rotating the IOL, you again marked the reference axis, no? And then you marked 130.
Oh, yeah.
There's another way, which we can do is, like the lens, it required 87 degree of clockwise rotation. So you take those toric marks at zero.
All right.
And you do 87 degree clockwise, because then you don't get that 4 to 5 degree of error, which can again arise because of the reference.
Yeah, got it.
Marking. Yeah,
the point I want to make is this is the case not for rotation but for exchange, because even after the rotation, it was showing a high amount of residual.
Two adapters.
Yeah.
And sir, any tip on whatever happened, but handling the patient also with all this premium lens.
Only thing, because these are older patients. By doing the biopics, we need to be concerned about the dry eye status about these patients. So we need to be prepared that we need to use lubricants for a much longer time. That is one extra point.
Yes, ma'am. And to answer his question exactly, the patient is not very old also. He's a middle-aged man. I accepted the first post-operative day only. I accepted the fault to him. I said, this is something wrong with my calculation. I will try to get the best from me. The patient was from Trivandrum. He's such an excellent person. He really cooperated to all the procedures. I'm thankful to the patient also.
Good. That was a good learning video.